Well, to other news, and Stephen Miles says his new cabinet will get straight to work following the biggest overhaul to the ministry in almost a decade. A key Olympics portfolio has been scrapped, with the Premier saying he doesn't want the Games to be a distraction for the government.
Stepping into a new era of the Miles ministry.
It's fantastic to have our ministry sworn in and they'll be straight to work.
The Olympics, once a source of pride and joy for Anastasia Palaszczuk, has been scrapped from any job title. Responsibility for the 2032 Games now falling on Grace Grace, who's adding state development and infrastructure to her roles.
We got the Olympics and we will make them fantastic.
But without the sense that our government is distracted by it.
Bart Mellish is the Minister for Transport, Main Roads and Digital Services after Mark Bailey jumped before being pushed.
I've known Mark for a long time. I think he's done a very good job. We've got to make sure we're keeping a tight rein on costs.
Nikki Boyd will take on fire, disaster recovery and corrective services.
I'll be looking to get up to Cairns.
Mark Ryan stays on as Police Minister with the addition of community safety.
There are more reforms that we will obviously have to focus on.
The decision makers are the same ones who've been making decisions for the last nearly decade.
Youth Justice Minister Di Farmer gains education, while Cherise Mullen is the new Child Safety Minister, also in charge of Seniors and Disability Services and Multicultural Affairs.
It's the front line that I'm really interested in.
Cairns MP Michael Healy will eventually be the Minister for Tourism and Sport, but he's stranded in the far north dealing with the disaster. So for the time being, the Deputy Premier has been sworn into the role. Lance McCallum is the employment minister, the Gubbi Gubbi man becoming the first First Nations man in cabinet.
I'd like to pay tribute to those that have come before me.
Under the new leadership, new ministers will be expected to hit the ground running with 10 months to go until the next election.
And now, everyone, it's time to get to work.
Thank you. Thank you.
After giving themselves a round of applause, Marlena Wobb, 7 News.